What's going on, guys? Dr. Brute 7 signing in back with another tutorial video. So I'm going to be showing you guys how to set up EmuNAND on your Nintendo Switch. So this video is specifically for the first time jailbreak users, not for the users who have been on SysNAND for quite some time. You guys just don't even take this approach because it's going to be useless for you guys. SysNAND users, including myself, we have already exposed our Nintendo Switch by running different types of unsigned codes that are already flagged by Nintendo. You're going to get banned. First time users who are new to jailbreak, who owns a fresh Nintendo Switch capable of jailbreaking and has a clean NAND, has never been exposed to any unsigned codes or stuff or previous jailbreak on SysNAND, then this video goes out to you. You'll be able to set up EmuNAND and be able to take the full advantage of it. So what EmuNAND does is basically it creates an emulated system partition which contains all the necessary system files and stores them into the SD card, thus keeping the original system partition on the Nintendo Switch clean or safe. You can switch back to official firmware mode and you can go online or connect to the Nintendo servers. Make sure that you have a working SysNAND before creating an EmuNAND. What this means is that the jailbreak files needs to be proper. Let me handle that part. I will provide you guys with the proper files, which you just need to download and then follow through the video. If you want to know about Switch jailbreak or how to start or move into step into jailbreaking and what stuff that you guys need to know about jailbreaking, then there is a video that I have made. I'm going to post the link sometime right now. Use a micro SD card that has good storage space because it's going to need a good amount of space on your SD card. So I would recommend using from 256GB to 512GB. That's going to be the best or ideal size for you guys. For some reason I'm getting the FAT32 partition here, but you might not get the FAT32 on the latest version of Windows. They don't have the FAT32 format. For some reason I'm getting this. It's kind of surprising. If you don't get this option through the traditional formatting method or procedure, then there is a link that I'll be posting that will help you to download a freeware and you'll be able to format your SD card to the FAT32. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and do a quick format and this will erase all the data. It's also advisable that your Switch's SD card format is on FAT32 because it's the preferred format. I myself, on my primary SD card, I'm an exFAT user and I intend to keep it that way. Now, just go to the link on the description and download the RAR file. Just extract the contents. You're going to get a folder. Just copy all the contents and then paste it to the root of your SD card. For Tegra RCM users, just make sure to go to the second link in the description and just download the payload file. That's how you're going to boot into Hecate and then boot into fuse.bin. Yeah, that's how you're going to boot into Atmosphere. RCM loaders, use the same link. Connect your RCM loader, go into the Atmosphere Hecate folder and paste the payload.bin file. So now here we are done with all the stuffs that we are required for the EmuNAND partition. I'm going to meet you guys on the Nintendo Switch. I've already used my RCM loader to boot into Hecate. This is the first screen that you're going to get. One pointer while trying to boot into Hecate through the RCM loader. If you're going to get a black screen, do not panic. It is completely normal. It happened to me till I just, you know, managed to boot into Hecate. So usually it might happen if the RCM loader is in low power mode, you know, or needs to be charged. So make sure that your RCM loader is charged properly. There is no need to panic, the files are completely fine. So on this screen you can set up the date and time if you want to. If not, you can just select done. So this here is where you're going to perform the EmuNAND creation process. So go to EMU MMC and select create EMU MMC. Always select SD partition because SD file is not stable, there is a chance of data corruption. So SD partition is the way to go. And here this here is the thing that is the second step. My partition has already been created, so now it's understandable why it was showing FAT32 on the computer when I was trying to format it. So the partition for the transferring of the files into MUMMC was already detected. So for you guys, what's gonna happen is when you're going to select create EMUMMC and select SD partition, you're going to get another screen. I'm going to post a picture, and all you have to do is just drag that red bar till you see it's 29 and says full. After that, just go ahead and select next, and it's going to, you know, back up all the files. So before performing that step, always make sure that if you want to back up your files on the SD card or stuff, just back it up before on the PC, because you're going to lose all those files. Now, after that process has been completed, you're going to head over into EMUMMC again, then create EMUMMC, and this here screen that you're going to see, the part one is going to get highlighted. I'm just gonna go ahead and select part one, and it's going to do its thing. It takes a little bit of time. I'm just gonna come back or step right back in once the process has been completed. Yeah, there you go, it's done. Time taken 15 minutes and 41 seconds. The MUNAND process creation, or however you want to put it, has been completed. So I'm just gonna go ahead and close this. As you can see, it says it has been enabled. This is basically what you need to see. So guys, so after finishing with that process of creating the MUNAND and just, you know, transferring of the files and everything, go to payloads and boot into fuse.bin, and it's going to boot into Atmosphere. If you notice in the system settings, the current version of Switch's firmware is 14.1.0. Atmosphere is on its latest version 1.3.1, and as you can see, it's E instead of S, so that means we are on MUNAND right now. So that means MUNAND has been successfully set up. So okay, so we are on the homebrew menu. I'm just going to show you guys by running tinfoil to show you that everything is running perfectly fine. So I'm using the tinfoil self installer. Just go ahead and perfect. As you can see, tinfoil has booted up. So yeah, this is how you set up MUNAND on your Nintendo Switch. So yeah, the Switch's original system partition is completely safe from any kind of exposure. You guys would be able to boot into the official Switch's firmware and would be able to connect to the Nintendo server. Let's just say you want to play with your friends on Fortnite or any other games that are multiplayer games and needs internet connection, you'd be able to do so without having to worry about getting banned. Finally, so MUNAND creation process has been completed. So from now on, for any kind of Switch's updates and stuff like that, I will be covering both the SysNAND and the MUNAND. That was it for this one. If you found this tutorial useful, please make sure to drop in a like and subscribe. We are already on the way to 1,000 subscribers. Very much excited. Until next time, Dr. Root 7 signing off. Peace.